The next item is boundary bunds and contour bunds in the rainfed lands. This diagram shows the boundaries of various lands in the rainfed areas. Example, this is survey number 27 and this is survey number 23. That's some arbitrary numbers are given here to illustrate the issue of boundary bunds and contour bunds. Now, in these areas, the contours are something like this, as shown in dotted red line. That means any ground along this line is of the same level. The ground level along this line in all these fields is at the same level. And if contour bund has got to be constructed for this land, it has to be done in this manner along the contour. And when it is done along the contour, it divides the field into two parts. Usually the farmers don't agree for such subdivision of their lands because that would interfere in their agricultural operations. And also they feel that it is occupying most of their land useful for crops. Usually the farmers in the whole country were resisting against such contour bunds during the past several decades. And therefore, in actual practice, they were executing bunds along the boundary in this manner. While executing the bunds along the boundary, in some places, they have called them as contour bunds, even though it's not according to contour and it is executed along a topographic boundary of the field. Still, it went under the nomenclature of contour bund, and the design norms of bund sections were adopted in this manner from here to this point. In the earlier instances, they used to construct a contour bund as shown in the dotted line, like this, of the same uniform height all the places. The height is uniform. Here also the same height as that of here. And that height used to be about 0.5 meters. So the top of the bund used to be something like this. And when it is done like this, water gets collected here, and during heavy rains, it causes a breach. It used to get breached here at the center. And these breaches, in turn, will cause further breaches down below in the other fields. So the contour bunds constructed along the boundary were not serving the purpose of soil moisture conservation, and it resulted in damages. Now, when the farmers don't agree for the contour bund to be executed in their field, dividing this into two bits, the only choice available is to build it along the boundary, though it may not be to the contour. And when it has got to be done along the boundary, we have to adopt what is called boundary bund technology and not contour bund technology. Now, what is that boundary bund technology? That is nothing but constructing a bund as shown here in thick line, which will have a greater depth at the lower point and a lesser depth at the higher point, and we don't have the bund at all at the ends. For example, in the plan, the bund starts from here and there is no need for a bund for this length because already high up, and there is no need for the bund for this length. It can be limited to a shorter distance like this, and it is wider here, bund section is wider here because the depth is more. For example, depth here is 0.8 meter, whereas depth here is 0.2 meter. And it varies in depths, but it is horizontal at one level for the entire reach of the bund. The top is horizontal. The top is not sloping as shown in the dotted line here. The top is horizontal at the same level throughout. And when the depth of water stored here at the center is considerable than at the ends, the bund has got to be of sufficient height to withstand the water pressure, and therefore it is having a greater height with a greater base width. Now let us see the sections at these points AA, BB and CC. Now this is the section at one end and section AA. Here the depth is 0.3 meter and the side slope is 1:1. Top width is 0.5 meter and when we give side slope of 1:1, the bottom width works out to 1.1 meter. And at some other place, it is 0.5 meters depth and it is having 1:1 side slope with 0.5 meter top width, and with this side slope, the bottom width works out to 1.5 meter. And the third section, let us see, the maximum section is having 0.8 meter depth, that is at the center, and it is having a bottom width of 2.1 meter and top width of 0.5 meter and side slope of 1:1, and this section would be at the bottom most level along the boundary. Now let us see the cross section areas. The first one with 0.3 meter depth has got a cross section area of 0.24 square meters. And the second one is usually adopted in the contour bund with a 0.5 meter depth, which works out to half square meter. This is the section usually used for contour bund. Now instead of this section, we use a lesser section in the ends and we use a bigger section at the middle where the ground level is the lowest. So here we provide a bigger bund with 1 square meter as the area of the bund. This will be higher than the contour bund area of 0.5 square meter and it is compensated by a lesser height of bund at the ends. So in effect, there won't be any increase in cost due to the boundary bund technology. The same contour bund costs only would be applicable to boundary bund technology also. But the point here is, we have a much lesser section at the ends and a bigger section at the middle. The advantage in having like this is that when water is collected here, the bund is having sufficient section and it will be stable under the water collected conditions here. It won't get breached. But still, there would be a possibility of very heavy rainfall when it occurs. There would be greater storage and there should be a facility for the water to spill out. At the end of the bund, we provide a small paved bywash, a rough stone paved a surplus arrangement at the end. It can be provided here or it can be provided here depending upon how the natural wagu or natural drainage pattern is there at the field. So the choice is left to the farmer, either to have here or to have here. If supposing the drainage course is somewhere like this, with a short distance it can join here. If suppose the drainage course or wagu is somewhere here or a small drain is somewhere here, it can join that drain. So this is the arrangement if the contours are like this, which indicates in the boundary there will be a very low ground level at the center and a high ground level at the end. Let us now examine another type of terrain where the contours are something like this, shown in dotted red line. This is a higher contour, lower and a further lower contour, which means the ground is sloping like this. And if a contour bund has got to be constructed in this field with these boundaries, the normal practice or the textbook practice is to construct a bund along the contour like this. If a bund is constructed like this, it would be divided into two bits, and the farmers do not agree generally. As already said, their agricultural operations would get hindered and they feel inconvenienced by any such bund going right through in their fields. They also have a feeling that they lose the land considerably if it is done like this. And therefore, they want the bund along the boundary. If it has to be done along the boundary, let us see the sectional elevation of this. The boundary is something like this. It is higher ground here and it falls, and this is the lowest ground. And if a contour bund section will have to be executed along the boundary, it will be built something like what is shown in dotted line here. That means it will have the same height of 0.5 meter here, it would have the same height of 0.5 meter as well as the same height as 0.5 meter. Now, if such contour bund section is constructed along the boundary of this type, then we can easily imagine what would be the result of that. The water gets collected in this low ground. There won't be any water here at all because the slope is like this. Falling down slope is like this. So the water will get collected, and when it increases a particular height, it breaches here. And for because the section is the same here as well as here also, so the section here is the same as the section here. There is no need for a bund here, and there is a need for a bigger height of bund here, but it is provided according to the contour bund section of 0.5 meter height. So therefore, it causes a breach here, and continuous breaches happen down below, one breach below the other. This has actually happened in several cases, and I would like to quote one Vice Chancellor of Karnal Agricultural University, Haryana. He was telling me during some of our joint inspections and visits that the farmers, some of the farmers in Haryana have reported to him that there was some erosion earlier to the contour bund formation, but after the contour bunds are formed, the erosion got increased and there was severe breaches of bunds constructed, and that led to much severe erosion. And the farmers were mentioning, we don't know what to do now. You wanted us to do the contour bunding to reduce the soil erosion, and the contour bunding was done, but the soil erosion never got reduced, but on the other hand, it increased very much more. So that is the situation when we come across, if a contour bund section of uniform height is constructed along a boundary where the boundary terrain is sloping with a high ground level here to a low ground level there. So in such cases, the boundary bund technology has got to be adopted. I purposely coined this word boundary bund technology. This is not done so far, and therefore we have to now coin a different technology for this. The reason for not developing a boundary bund technology is hitherto that the scientists were insisting that contour bund alone should be done and not along a sloping ground. But now when we see the preferences of farmers and because we have to go according to choice of farmers, the contour bund was not possible to execute in their fields when the fields are sloping in this manner. So the farmers insist upon doing the bund only on the boundary, and hitherto it was done in the boundary adopting the contour bund section of uniform height. So it requires a change as shown here. The contour bund section is not adopted at all in this. It is the boundary bund technology, so called boundary bund technology, with no bund here, with a bund from here to this point, and section elevation, its a starting point is here and the bund ends here. The height of the bund is 0 to 0.2 and things like that, and as it comes here the height of the bund is more. The top of the bund is horizontal, that is to the same level, and it is given also a return so that when water is collected here the water can spill, and this is the surplus arrangement here. In the previous sketch we have seen the surplus arrangement was at a different place. So in this case, because the slope is like this falling down, the water will get collected here and it exceeds a particular depth of storage, it spills over and joins the nearby drain. So this is the type of boundary bund that has got to be executed when the land is sloping like this. Like this, depending upon the terrain slopes, we have to incorporate the boundary bund technology wherever the contours are in a different manner and the boundaries are on sloping ground.